Hey, we're not gonna push down. We're gonna push up. All right.
Things are never quite what they seem.
We're not gonna check the body. We're gonna get the knife. The world all right. Around us,
but we really only see the outside, what it seems.
And we're gonna do a run, and then we're gonna get a good time. And then
humanity, the newspapers,
gonna be like, wow, all these dialogues aren't right. And then do another run.
The world kicks you in the
eventually.
And you don't have any choice but to see things the way they really are. My name is Lucas Kane. My story is the one where an ordinary guy has something extraordinary happened to him. Maybe it was supposed to happen. Maybe it was my destiny or my karma or whatever. I know one thing for sure.
Dialogue. I know, right? It should just be dialogue. The first one. I don't know why you had to spell it so weird. Dialogue. That does not this. This is the same. It's dialogue. Dialogue. The second one. That's how it sounds.
It all started right.
You pronounce
here.
It.
Where else could it happen?
Dialogue-y. Dialogue-y.
The chessboard destiny chose for the last big game. I was just another pawn living my pawn's life. Until that night, when my life descended into chaos.
It's definitely faster by at least half a second to go to the back door. I can get a 0.9 for time save on the first one. Might even be able to get more than that. I don't know, my gold's pretty solid though. Right now, yeah, you're probably gonna get caught, but it's best to make sure.
I've got to get out of here before somebody comes in here.
Fuck off. That shit. I pushed the analog too early. Today is just not my day, I guess.
I need to get out of this neighborhood before the police get here.
Should be fine. To continue anyway. At least I recovered somewhat decent.
Nobody goes anywhere. A crime has just been committed. I'm going to have to ask you to stay calm and wait here for the police to arrive and check your IDs.
Yeah, it was fine. I'm surprised.
Doc's Diner. That's it. Why do they always wait for me to go on duty before they start killing each other in the middle of the night?
Tyler, somebody gets murdered every day in New York.
But especially when I'm on night duty. It's as if every psycho in the city has it in for me.
If you want a bitch, do it inside. That way I don't have to...
Hey, push up on the knife.
You're the boss, Carla.
How's it going, McCarthy?
Evening, Inspector. I've been waiting for you. Hey, Tyler.
Hey, Martin.
So, what happened?
Homicide. I found the body in the toilets. I had to go before I went home.
Do we have a suspect?
A client left just before I found the body.
Thanks for your help.
Oh,
Martin.
I see the red X that you're talking about.
I'm gonna wait until you're finished with Kate, if you don't mind. I want to make sure she gets home okay.
Hey, push up, not down. There you go.
Unless there's a gang running
around. Got to the door a little slow, but whatever.
I think I might have found the murder weapon.
Great.
Maybe we lost a second there.
On the handle.
Okay.
Kate? I'm Inspector Carla Valenti. I'm in charge of the investigation here. Would you mind answering a few questions?
Oh, I don't remember the tutorial having that.
Go ahead.
Maybe it does, and I just don't know.
Can you tell me what you saw?
There weren't that many.
So what about for this one? Did we just push you then?
I was just
and then down
with Martin at the bar. I didn't even see John get up. Oh my God.
You have to try.
Because that's what it's doing. Because it's defaulting to you, but it's skipping the other ones.
Only one who can help us.
Some reason.
My shift was almost over. I was just chatting with Martin at the bar. John got up and went to the restroom. The man must have followed.
I thought it was because it skipped the dialogues, but it might just because of the certain path we're taking right now, which is
Martin went to the restroom.
You and then down.
And that's when you found John.
Do you think that you would recognize?
Because it defaults to you, you know.
I'll never forget that face.
Perfect.
I don't know.
Do you think that you could come down to the station tomorrow and help us construct?
That'd be a good thing to test.
Yeah, I'll do whatever you think I can to help catch him.
Thank you very much for your help, Kate.
You go you and then down
the
for.
The bastard who did it. People like that just don't deserve to live.
I promise you, we'll do everything.
Like Y O U you.
Go home now.
Yeah.
Try to get some sleep. Martin will make sure you get home okay.
Should be up.
Good night.
You ready to go, Tyler? I think I've seen everything I need to see.
Are you sure? We can take another look around if you want.
Nope, we're good. Let's head home.
Okay, let's bust.
It's time to get back to the car. I'm dead tired.
Alright, so I need to grab the medicine here for mental health for a later segment. We change the route up, or Dragonbane trains the route up a bit, make it a lot faster. Sacrifice more mental health later, so we need medicine here.
It all really happened. I'm gonna get ready and go to work.
I'm not very good at the prompts, so we'll see how it goes.
Gotta make it stop.
Yep.
That should help my migraine.
Went as good as I expected.
Reads, don't take with alcohol.
Push my camera, it might fuck me. Hopefully not. First segments are important now.
It's good to hear.
At least this one is. For mental health.
I noticed maybe you wanted to go to Mom and Dad's tomb together. And to be honest, I thought it might be a good excuse to get back in touch with you.
And they're all pretty important. Chapter 1 has the start of the mental health route.
What are you talking about, Lucas? What happened?
I can't really talk about it on the telephone. It's serious, Marcus.
I'll meet you in half an hour at the park.
Saying nothing actually isn't you? Oh. I wash our hands here instead of taking a shower, which is 7 second time save. But it gets canceled out by taking the medicine, so it's even. It comes out to be about even, but washing your hands is a lot faster than taking a shower. You don't have to go to the cabinet and don't have to get out of the shower and stuff. God, I almost messed that up. He was about to go right.
New York police, please open the door.
Police, they know. They've come to arrest me.
Police, open up.
Just a minute, I'm coming.
I can't let them find any evidence linking me to last night. I've got a couple seconds to hide everything before I get the door.
Sir, this is the New York police. Are you Lucas Kane?
Yes.
Mr. Kane, the neighbors heard yelling from your apartment. Is there a problem?
Yelling? No, there must be some mistake. I'm alone here, and I was sleeping.
Would it be all right if I took a little look around your apartment?
Whatever. Go ahead.
Do what now? So that's why we want to try silence on every dialogue with PS2 stage stick.
Oh, it's nothing, just a stupid accident.
If it's faster, yeah, true.
You cut yourself, you go all the way, don't you?
Gonna be a lot of stuff. If you don't grab the pieces of clothing, the officer sees it and you fail. And game's over.
He's gonna see the bloody sheet. No, please don't go in there.
Yeah? Why not?
We also can't grab this the clothing on the floor until we look out the door and the cop is knocking on the door.
Oh, I see. Thank you for your cooperation. Sorry to have bothered you, sir. You know how it is. With everything that's been going on, we prefer to be careful.
I understand.
Go on, Mr. Kane.
Time to leave. Fine.
When Marcus and I were kids, we were inseparable. He's the one who took care of me after our parents died. We kind of grew apart after he became a...
I'm happy to see you. I missed you.
That's just time saved from trying to take the medicine.
So tell me what's happened, Lucas.
Really slow.
I've killed a man.
Or time loss, I mean.
It happened at a restaurant last night. It's like I was
I don't know if I said time save or time loss.
It's like I was a puppet on a string. I saw what I was doing, but I was powerless to stop it.
My God. I can't believe this, Lucas. Tell me that it wasn't you. You're not capable of something like that. You went to this restaurant alone?
Yeah.
Oh, you can pick it up early?
We broke up about a month ago.
Gotcha.
I try to get out of the apartment as much as possible. It's just so empty there without her, you know. And there's this, too.
You cut your wrists?
Before the murder, I carved these symbols on my arms with a knife. I don't know if they mean anything.
Had you been drinking or taking drugs?
You know that I don't do that, Marcus.
Honestly, I think this conversation seems pretty good.
You're the only person that I can trust. There's something else you need to know.
It looks good, but who knows?
After the murder, I had these premonitions, like I was seeing things that hadn't happened yet. What happened to me, Marcus? What am I supposed to do now? You know me better than anyone, Marcus. Help me.
Listen, Lucas, I'm a bit lost here. This whole story is just so bizarre. Maybe
I meant like time-wise.
Professional help. Most cases of possession are known to actually stem from
Marcus. I don't have a psychiatric problem. I'm not crazy.
I am a priest, Lucas. The fact that you have taken a life is a very serious matter.
BB's been finding a lot of time save with dialogue. Marcus?
All these years and nothing
we're
changed.
Starting to think that the guy just kind of set up a good mental health route and didn't really time any of the dialogues.
My faith and my brother.
I'm not a murderer, Marcus. You're the only person I can trust. I'm just asking you to believe me.
Well, at least he got a pretty good base run. His run's solid, for sure. Without all the time saves, it's not that solid.
Look, I need to get some answers. I'll call you.
Here. You need this more than I do.
Marcus, you know that I don't believe in all that. It's gonna take a hell of a lot more than a crucifix to get me out of this.
Breaking off. Save 7 seconds, but costs minus 10 mental. Okay. Yeah, there's probably a pretty easy mental health gain somewhere, but then again, it'd probably last around 7 seconds. Unless you could find a good dialogue.
The cop in the restaurant. If
I don't do something, the child will die. If I do something, the cop will recognize me. What am I gonna do? Maybe I could have saved that kid. If I had it to do over again, I'd gladly sacrifice my life to save him. But it's too late now. Maybe it's my destiny.
At the moment, it's set up in a way where we can't really lose anymore, or else we're fucked.
I'm still free to try and find out what happened to me. But honestly, not a day's gone by since then that I haven't regretted that choice.
Guess I just split in the wrong spot.
I've got this really bad habit.
I usually split on the loading.
Once I start working on a case, I can't.
That's a real time.
I'm exhausted. I haven't gotten a wink of sleep all night. Something's bothering me about this murder, but I just can't seem to put my finger on what it is.
It's still good though. It's just the time loss from the medicine.
How you doing today?
Hi, Doug. Not too bad. Is Tyler here yet?
No, not that I know of.
Hey, Carla, can you tell your partner to pay me back that $100 he owes me? I've been waiting 6 months for it now.
Can't help you there, Jeffrey. Talk to him about it.
He's been avoiding me like the plague. Plus, you know, you're the only one he listens to.
Catch you later, Jeffrey.
Hi, Carla.
Hi, Garrett.
Oh, wait, Carla. I got some results back on the tests we did for that restaurant murder.
Great. As soon as Tyler gets here, we'll come and see you.
Okay, I'll be at my desk all morning.
It's all happened before. Kirsten, what's that supposed to mean?
Which guy? The Jeffrey guy that wants his money, or the other guy?
Tyler is still not here. I'd better try to give him a ring.
Yeah.
Know what time it is?
I don't know. It doesn't really sound.
Shit.
Get a move on. The waitress is coming this morning to flesh out the composite on the killer.
This guy has like a pretty.
I'm on my way.
Not like a heavy New York accent, but he definitely has like a New York accent. The doc doesn't really have an accent. For American. I guess it's not an accent for me, but. American accent, I guess. Old man American accent.
Stay a little longer.
Sorry, babe, but I really gotta go.
I'll make some coffee.
Okay, I'll grab a shower, get dressed, and then I'm out of here.
I speak American. I don't know how she pulls. Yeah, how she sounds like him. I mean, Timmy Turner from Fairly Odd Parents is a girl, but his voice is a lot higher. I think she plays a lot of male actors in cartoons. I don't remember what her name is.
Go back to bed, Sam. You're gonna catch a death of cold like that.
I'm not cold.
Look, Sam, please don't start. I got no intention of dying today.
I'm sick of living in fear like this. Every morning I'm terrified that something's gonna happen to you.
I know how you feel, Sam. You just
man, too bad we can't just transfer all of Tyler's mental health to
Well, what if you quit?
To, we could what's his name?
And take over my parents' store. We'd have a normal life.
The Lucas.
We could have a baby.
I'm just not made for that kind of life, Sam. I've been around too much violence all my life to go live some kind of normal life like that. I know you love me.
That'd be stupid, though.
So try to understand me, too.
Nice. What the hell, Joel?
Aren't you going to kiss me?
You're so edgy.
Tyler, no!
Edgelord. Edgelord Joel at it again.
Hi, Tyler. Oh, Carl is looking for you.
Yeah, I know. So, you ready for retirement, man?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Hi, Tyler. That's my favorite
Tyler,
actor right there.
You know,
hi, Tyler.
Just the guy I was looking
so
for.
Good.
Oh, shit.
You remember that $100 I loaned you about 6 months ago? I'd really like for you to get that back to me as soon as possible. Like maybe now, for example?
Jeffrey, don't tell me you're prepared to ruin a beautiful friendship for $100 lousy dollars.
This may surprise you, but yes. So give up the cash before I start to
this
get
this guy doesn't
really
sound
angry.
Anything like the doc.
Yo, let me make you a deal. I'll play you a game of b-ball for your $100. If you win, I'll give you $200.
What are you
right
talking
then.
About?
But if you lose...
Are you sure? Are we talking about the right doctor?
If I win.
You got my word.
Oh, man. The other guy.
All right, you're on.
Gotcha.
But don't even think about
I'd have to hear him again.
If you lose,
or we're that, about to hear him in a little
don't
bit.
Don't worry, Jeffrey. I'll come by and see you when I get 5 minutes. The waitress hasn't come in yet?
She won't be long. Garrett got the lab results. Shall we go?
All right, let me hang up my coat. I'll be right with you.
Okay. See you in a minute.
Me and Tyler have the same hat. Like, my hat literally looks like that. Except it's more colorful. We're like twins. Except not.
So, what do you want to start with?
Hat twins.
What did you find on the knife?
Got some good prints off it.
This guy?
They matched those found on the fork and glass at the suspect's table.
So, the murderer was definitely at that table.
Anything on the blade?
I'm getting to that. We definitely had blood from the victim, but the weird thing is we also found blood
maybe.
From the killer. Frank found a book on one of the tables in the diner. It was Shakespeare.
I don't know.
The Tempest, I think.
Did you check for prints?
Yep.
I don't know about that, yeah.
The fork and the glass, so it was definitely his book. It looked like a fairly old book. Maybe we can get some more stuff out of it. So, what do you think about all that?
Not a whole lot right now. This case just doesn't make sense. There's something not right here.
You know, with all the weirdos running around loose these days, nothing makes any sense anymore. These killers, half the time, they don't know why they did it. The world's going crazy, Carl, I'm telling you.
Thanks for your help, Garrett. See you later.
So, what do we do now?
You go take care of the composite. I'm gonna go check with the coroner and see if he got anything from the body.
Okay. Catch you later.
I was burning with fever. I was shaking all over. The migraine was back, drilling holes into my brain.
Back ahead.
Top it off. I couldn't keep any food down.
The point two.
My body seemed to be fighting against something, but I still didn't know what. Gotta just live my life no matter what. Don't raise any suspicions.
Despite the state I was in, I decided to go to work as though nothing had happened. I'm in charge of computer maintenance in the Nacer and Jones Bank. I share my office with...
You okay, Lucas? You're all white.
Oh, got a little cold, that's all.
Sure, it's faster to say something to Martin. To who? Wait, what do you mean? I'm not sure about anything. I'm just going off of whatever route was in the Discord.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Lucas Kane.
Hello, Lucas.
Oh, hello, Tiffany.
I left a message on your machine last night. I'd like to come and pick up some stuff at your place. Could I come over tonight?
I should be back home around 8 o'clock tonight.
Okay, it won't take too long. Are you doing okay, Lucas?
I gotta let you go. I'm doing a thing here. Bye.
Time to do these Simon Says. Oh no.
Hello? Yes, sir. We'll get on that right away. Station 62 is down. I'll go.
No, me.
No, forget it. I'll handle it.
Whatever you say.
Just leave this coffee cup there. Doesn't crash anymore, Joel, remember? Oh, true. Yeah, time for the crash. You're right. Thank you. That'd be a pretty good time loss sound. I'll have to record it.
Woe to he who sees both sides of the snake.
1 to 2 second gold? Nice. Just say nothing to the cop the first time?
Lucas? Lucas, what happened?
Damn.
Can you hear me? Are you all right?
Hey, you've hurt yourself. You're bleeding.
I gotta go.
Gotta go.
I didn't have the slightest idea what had happened. The one thing I do know, those things almost killed me.
That's a good time save for there. Because I've already had the 5 seconds from earlier, but then I've lost it. So.
Okay, we're going to get started. If you prefer, you can wait outside.
I'd rather stay here if you don't mind. I've studied some medicine. I've seen dead bodies.
Oh. As you wish. No apparent hematoma on the body.
That's so weird. Yesterday when we got to this point, I felt like it had already been 2 hours or something.
Large hematoma.
Time flies when the timer's on.
Fracture of the occipital bone. Abnormal dilation in both pupils. 3 knife wounds between the 3rd and 5th ribs in the proximity of the heart. The blade was driven in deeply. The stabs seem to have been delivered from the front and moved from left to right. 1 stab neatly cut the
aorta. Could be the last one.
And the other 2 cut the left and right coronary arteries. They really didn't have a chance. The blade slipped right through the ribs to cut the arteries.
It was definitely the knife wounds that caused his death?
Yes. The 3 arteries leading to the heart were cut. The heart was literally disconnected from the rest of the body.
Do you think it was just by chance?
Difficult to say. The chances of cutting all 3 main arteries to the heart with 3 lucky stabs are fairly small, but, it's not impossible.
Guy's great.
I saw a case like this once before. It was a while back now, in the 90s, I think. Exactly the same. 3 stabs around the heart, each one cutting a main artery. It really struck me at the time. I wondered how such a thing were possible. It was the, what was that name again? Karsten or Kirsten, something like that.
Kirsten?
Yes, that's it, Kirsten. You know about that case?
Not yet. I'm sure as hell gonna find out.
Come in.
Hello, Detective.
Hello, Mrs. Morrison. Thanks for taking the trouble to come down. Please, take a seat.
The auto splitter seems to be holding up pretty good. No incidental resets yet.
We have a computer program to help us. You'll see, it's really simple. It's kind of like a video game. Have you ever played a video game, Mrs. Morrison?
No.
It doesn't matter. You're going to do fine. The most important thing is to try to remember exactly what happened. The program consists of several types of facial features.
All right, let's see what we get today.
You scroll through them until it looks like the man you saw.
They're going to be a double?
Yes. Well, I think I do.
Okay, let's go. Now, is this
not a double
face
yet.
Of the person you saw?
Damn. There's just so many options.
At least, that's how I remember him.
Thank you very much for your help. We're going to get this picture out to all the airports, trains, and bus stations, and to all of our patrolmen. If this guy is still in New York, we're going to find him. And go buy yourself a video game.
Alright, gotta take pills again. Always gonna be up. That's good to know. Pillhead, haha. Then I can also get into the bed instantly without having to worry. Yeah, besides all the new prompts, run's been going pretty good.
Hi.
Hi.
I came to pick up my stuff. I hope I'm not disturbing.
No, I'm just a little bit sleepy. Come in. Have a seat.
All right. Let's see here. If I get this prompt good for setting the box down, I'd save a good amount of time. I mean, I won't save time, but I'll not lose as much time.
They shouldn't be too hard to find. They've got my initials on them.
Yeah, that's fine. Better than PB.
They are. I think that's everything.
Is everything okay, Lucas? You look stressed.
I'm just fine, thanks.
That's good.
I think it would probably be best if you left now.
You're right. Thanks for everything.
Oh, that is weird. Guess that's why you did it.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't want to. Maybe it was better this way. After all, I had no idea.
Oh, come on. That was dumb. What could I offer at this point? Prompt. To a girl like Tiffany? Are you gonna do a run of this? That'd be pretty cool. Okay, that's a good amount of time to lose from just getting pills.
10 years.
That seems normal. It's like 6 to 7 seconds to get the pills.
Killed in a car accident. I've never completely recovered from losing them.
I'm happy that you could come.
Oh, really? Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, I probably do already have it. That's pretty cool. We're going for... World record. In the corner.
Lucas.
World record improvements. I don't know why I didn't say that at first.
Lucas?
We're going for the real world record, which is a run with no major mistakes.
You, Lucas? You're always off by yourself. You never talk to anyone. You never play with anyone. I'm starting to think maybe you're crazy.
Oh yeah! Oh my god, I forgot about this.
Come on, do me a favor. Just play with everybody this one time.
I can't believe I forgot about it. I looked at my notes and saw Plane Boy, and I was like, oh yeah. Then I saw you say that.
How about hide and seek? We could go play in
there. Try not to miss a cycle, for sure.
No way. You know we're not allowed to play in there. Who cares? We can get in through
this
that
is the big time, one of the big time saves that DB found Jewel coming up here. Huge.
Good idea. Let's do it.
After this whole cycle thing. And also, I figured out you could just stand here because after the cutscene, it fixes your position. You can even run wherever you want, and it'll still put you in the same spot. And hopefully this strat works. Ah!
Hangar 4. It's gonna burn. Marcus and the others will get caught on the
that
fire.
That should be my time loss sound.
We've got
for sure.
Too late.
That'd be pretty good. Yeah, that was a good idea, Joel. I've been like trying to get new sounds for stuff, but I just can't come up with anything good. I'll just do it after the stream or something after this run. I can do it really easily. I've been messing around with Audacity a bunch. You can make sound clips super easily. It's coming up here, if I get this cycle at least. Looks like I got it. It's a surprise, you'll see. Have you seen this part before? Where you like run around and find all the kids in the hangar.
Lucas, what are you doing here? I thought you didn't want
to
play.
Not really. Well, normally at the find, oh, we used to find all of them, but
huh? How can that
DB figured out a way to skip all the finding and saves a lot. See if I can get it some smooth movement. Oops. Whatever. It works. Oh! Didn't get stuck behind the boxes. Nice. Got stuck behind that though.
Lucas, get out! Nobody wants to play with you.
You need to get out of here, Kurt.
Oh, this is a time save right here. This dialogue. Because this is the only kid you can talk to. And DB found if you pick the right dialogue, you can just leave. And it ends it. And that's why we've got the mental health boost earlier from the medicine. So we sacrifice 14 seconds to gain over a minute, almost. Maybe like... not a minute, like, it was like 40-something seconds, 50-something seconds. Forget what it was. Maybe it is over a minute.
You know they'll never believe that.
This is gonna be a huge gold. I'm excited. Yeah, waste 14, save 61. I knew it was something like that.
I did a little checking around, without giving your name. I was told about a person who is familiar with, let's say, unusual phenomena.
Okay, we gotta pick Tyler.
I think that maybe she
pick Tyler,
her.
Pick Tyler.
Here, this is her address.
Do not pick Carla. Go left.
You know
no,
I
go right.
Any of this, Lucas, but
not
I
left.
Sincerely hope she can give you some kind of answer.
Right.
I hope so too.
Oof.
I had some shit on my
That's huge.
I knew Samantha was depressed, but I didn't know what I could really do about it. I was happy to be back in here.
Man, I big. Like smell That's big.
Leather, sweat. Maybe I could just forget about everything for an hour and just get in a good workout with Carla. Damn, you look a little out of it, Carla. You sure you're cool?
The other minute was from not getting the truck first cycle. I had a reload.
Let me know when you're ready.
Okay, sounds good.
Alright, let's not drop this.
Two,
three, if you drop it a little bit, it starts slowing down.
Five, six,
pretty sure at least.
Seven.
Eight, I've had it go really slow, like way slower than this.
9, 10, 10. Yeah.
Maybe it doesn't matter
pretty
too
good
much.
Shape this morning. One more set and I'll be ready to get in the ring.
I don't care. I'm gonna mash it to the max anyway.
One.
No.
Two. Three. Four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine,
ten.
Ten. Cool. I'm ready to rock.
Yeah, I bet there's a different activity you could do. Or Tyler. That's true. This is a good thing to test.
One last set and I'll be ready to fight.
Test out some things for the workouts. I know this one's pretty fast, but I don't know about for Tyler. Maybe they're just all the same.
I'm warmed up. I'm ready to get
like
in the
same duration for Tyler. But yeah, good point.
For tonight's match between Terrible Tyler Miles.
And now we have to hope we don't get the bad cutscene. That's why we have a pretty good section.
Oh yeah. And who's always kicking out the crap?
And also not the bad dialogue. Maybe you need the bad cutscene to get the good dialogue. Who knows? It's probably just a coincidence that I got the bad dialogue when I didn't get the bad cutscene. I know the dialogue at the end is really long, but that cutscene is also really long. They're pretty similar in how long they are, honestly. Alright, Joel, thanks for hanging out, man. Hope you have a good night or morning, wherever it is, where you are. Hey, what's up, Masu? How have you been, dude?
Shower and get back to work
fast.
Can't get that restaurant murder out of your head, huh?
I just feel like there's a piece of the...
Doing all right. Me and DB, well, mostly DB, has been, like, breaking this game down, and we're just trying to get a good time on it right now. I've just been running it a bunch. I've found a couple things, but it's mostly been DB finding a bunch of cool route changes in this game lately.
I hope it's that simple, Tyler. I really do.
But yeah. Been going pretty good so far.
So, how's that restaurant
move? Ooh, yeah, that was a fat gold.
We've got another big one. Suspects for the moment. There's some troubling elements about this case.
We know it probably wasn't premeditated, and
this has to be the run. I can't fuck up. This is it.
Several elements match the MO of a ritual killing or a mystical trance. The choice of weapon, the killer's cutting himself, the manner in which the victim was stabbed with precise cuts to the heart. All this points to a religious sacrifice. He might be a Satanist.
Might not. I might stop talking.
Do you think there's much chance he'll kill again?
So
we don't have enough.
I can like focus entirely on the game and not mess anything up.
Hear from him again.
So if I stop talking, that's why.
Job behind bars ASAP. Do whatever you have to do.
So, what's the plan now?
Check the local hospitals to see if they've had any men with knife wounds in. Check with all the psycho wards to see if they've got any ex-patients out on the streets who might have been capable of something like this.
Okay, anything else?
Yeah, book we found under the table. Garrett left it on your desk. See if you can make anything of it.
Okay, I'll get on all that stuff right away. What are you gonna work on?
Get the talks, the cop dialogue as soon as possible.
As far back as I can remember, I've been frightened by small spaces.
I'll have to read that in a second.
Confined place, I start to panic.
You might just want to send me that one in the Discord, and I'll have to read it later. I can read it in the next cutscene for sure. Just scroll up.
Well, I had decided not to let my...
Yeah, I'll just read it in a little bit.
I decided to try and fight it every chance I got. I'm going to stay calm. Everything is going to be fine. I'm going to breathe deeply and walk without stopping until I find the computer terminal.
I can't really look away here. Unless I want to fail.
Here's the archive terminal. I can consult the file here. The save files are classified by year.
Okay, the next ones are right.
1990s. It shouldn't be too hard to find.
The worst one so far.
The electricity's cut. I just need to stay calm. I will control my fear. Thank you. are the files starting with K. Just need to check to make sure I've got the right year on the terminal.
Yeah, it was pretty good besides that one prompt. I did mess up another prompt, but it wasn't as bad as the first one.
Alright. I found it. File is empty. No report, no evidence, nothing. Wait. Here's the name of the detective in charge of the investigation. Robert Mitchell.
Nice.
Carla asked me to see what I could find out about the book we found.
Those backups, man. I'm telling you, that's what gave me that gold.
I inquired in the office and I ended up in a bookshop.
The back steps.
Old books run by a guy named Takeo.
This should also be a gold. Aw, oh, fuck. Man, I'm glad I messed that prompt up. It would have been a gold. I can't talk before I actually get it, or else it doesn't work out.
I'll check it out. I could go back to the office, but maybe Takeo could have told me a little more.
Still might be one, but I don't know. That prompt was slow. Oh, nice. Fucking car.
Here it is.
Why are you parking your car there?
Is there anyone here? Is anyone at home?
Oh my god. That's unfortunate. I pushed my joystick too early. Gotta stop Agatha? Doing that.
Why
it's the last time.
To talk to Agatha?
I was told that she could help me.
Help you? Tell me. Who on this earth doesn't need a little help? One need not have eyes to see. Be kind, young man. Push me over to my birds. It'll be more comfortable for us to talk over there.
Come on.
Oh my god. Reset, dude. Chapter is really bad so far. Guess it's time saved for next run.
Bird is such a unique animal. It can spend its entire life locked up in a cage and yet...
Not only is it the worst chapter in the game, it's the worst chapter speed-wise.
Tell me, what is your cage like?
I killed a man. It was like I was possessed. I watched it all happen, but I had no control over my actions.
Sounds like a rather commonplace story to me. Don't you think that it might simply be because you've gone mad?
You're right. Maybe I have gone mad. But I thought you could find some sort of explanation.
In the cupboard, you will find a little bag.
Probably already lost like 3 or 5 seconds here.
Good boy. Feed some to my little darling.
My PB was bad, but wasn't that bad. You probably recover it. But I doubt it. Go to the gold one first. A little awkward. I can get the dialogue faster.
Have you experienced any other strange manifestations since then? Have you had any odd dreams or visions?
Yes, I see things.
That's like the only reason why I do it. Because you do the same motion to get the dialogue back if you went to Silver One and then the Gold One.
Sign, maybe a word.
When I regained control of myself after the murder, this symbol had been cut into my wrist with a knife.
A snake. Two open jaws. Oh, dear God.
I'm gonna walk to this one.
What does it mean?
There's only one way for me to be sure. Please, push me
into the
scene.
What kind of camera angle it gives me? Shit one, of course.
You'll find some candles in one of the cupboards. Take them and place them in the candle holders. There should be some matches in the kitchen. Go find them and light the candles.
Nice. Really good. I've never had good prompts there, because I just haven't known them really well. I've done this section a couple of times, so... pretty easy to memorize it. Definitely more than a couple of times, but you know what I mean. Not even risking it. Just gonna walk. Room is too small. As long as I run to the wall, I should be able to get the window pretty easily.
Perfect. We're almost ready to begin. Turn off the light. Close the curtains, and sit down next to me.
Nice. Yeah, that's a good strat. Because normally if you run right to it, the crow gets in the way.
The only way to understand what has happened to you is to try to go deep into your unconscious memory.
Yes, I'm ready. Get it over with, please.
This murder has erased himself from your memory. But there still must be a trace in your unconscious. I can help you to locate it. It's an exhausting ceremony, and there's always a risk.
It's exhausting.
Do you or do you not wish to try it?
Yes, I do.
Give me your hands. Now, close your eyes. I want you to empty your mind.
Buckle up.
Open wide.
Ready for some fun?
Your unconscious, and let me enter there. That's it. We're still together. Lucas?
Yes.
Are you there?
Yes.
Love it.
I want you to return to the restaurant just before the events began. Evacuate all extraneous thoughts and wander freely through your memory. Where are you, Lucas?
I'm standing outside the restaurant.
You to enter the restaurant now.
Starts getting strict here, I think, so don't want to miss any.
I've gone into the restaurant.
What do you see?
I see some customers, and I see the waitress.
Can you see the table where you were sitting?
I'm looking. There's a police officer. He's sitting at the counter.
Concentrate, Lucas. Now, walk to your table.
I'm standing next to my table, but it's empty.
You haven't arrived and sat down there yet?
Yes, I have. My meal is already on the table. I think this is when I murdered him.
Stay calm, Lucas. I want you to tell me exactly where you are.
I'm in the restroom, and so is the other man.
What's he doing?
He's urinating. He doesn't suspect anything.
And you, Lucas? Where are you?
I don't know. I can't see myself. There I am. I was in a toilet stall. Oh my God. I'm holding a knife. He doesn't see me.
Calm yourself, Lucas. Keep your concentration.
I can't control myself.
I'm doing it.
I'm walking up behind the man. He doesn't see me.
I haven't blinked yet.
I don't want to. I don't want to, but I can't stop myself.
I want you to re-enter the restaurant. But now, it
I
is
blinked.
Prior
I lied.
To going into the toilet stall. Do you understand, Lucas? Before.
Blink on these ones, they're easy.
Where are you now?
I'm in the restaurant dining room again.
Are you sitting at your table?
Yes, I am. I can see myself.
What are you doing, Lucas?
I'm eating. I'm eating and reading a book.
A book?
Yes. Shakespeare. The Tempest.
What else do you see?
As I told thee before, I am subject to a tyrant. A sorcerer. That by his cunning hath cheated me of the island.
What did you say?
It's a passage from Shakespeare's Tempest. That's what you're reading, is it not?
Yes. Someone's coming toward me. A man.
Who is it?
God, that would be the worst freeze ever.
Know.
It just froze there and the Simon Says
face.
Infinitely kept going.
And what does he
say? Yeah, that would be funny, actually.
I don't know.
You're like, what's going on?
You must
sit here for 10 minutes.
You need to remember.
Still be doing time, it says.
It's one of my favorite books. A shame so few people read Shakespeare.
It looks like it's about to freeze there or something. They're just staring at each other.
Ah, it's just that the man sat down at my table and now the waitress is coming.
Sir?
I better have gotten that. I'm sure I pushed down.
Waitress,
pushed the left down.
It's as if she didn't see the man, like he was invisible.
So much has been written about.
I'm sure missing one's not gonna kill it.
Concerning the theme of magic.
And now, what's
it might.
Lucas?
I don't know. The man
gives
off a very strange energy. It's hard to describe.
Go on, Lucas. What happens after that?
Alright, we're good.
Do you believe?
Thank God.
The power of
sometimes if you miss one,
no,
just like
I don't.
Nope.
Listen,
sorry.
You're wrong. You know there's much more to our universe than can be perceived by the naked eye.
Your coffee, sir.
Thanks, Kate.
The
waitress is.
It makes it easier for you if you fail it too much.
To me as if I was the one who ordered it.
Because when I was testing if I could just fail out of this, it made it really easy.
And now what's happening?
Kind of interesting.
Listen, I don't want to be rude, but I'd rather.
Or maybe that's just for this one. Nah, it's the same. It was like giving me right every single time. It was like a direction on the left stick and then right every time. Really weird. It was either this one or it was a different one. I don't really remember.
My body. I can't move.
The man, Lucas. Where is the man?
He stood up. He's gone out. He's in my head now. He controls me.
Follow the man, Lucas. Hurry. I command you to follow that man closely.
He's going out the rear door.
Follow him. Your mind and his are now linked. You can see what he sees.
Done. Oof. That was quite the journey. I fucking hate this part. It's horrible.
Oh, God. You know who that man was, don't you, Agatha?
No. I don't know.
Oh.
I'm not sure who he is.
Yes, you do know who he is. You understood it all as soon as you felt the scars on my arms. What do these symbols mean, Agatha? Tell me what that man's done to me.
Only have 13 seconds of loading time so far. That's pretty neat.
You could at least explain what the hell's happening to me. He made me kill a man. I want to know. I need to know.
I have to
about 13
certain things. There's nothing more I can tell you today. Come back tomorrow night at the same time. I'll explain more then.
What? I got a gold. What is this, PB?
Training Sergeant Mitchell.
Did I not save my splits or something?
Thanks.
That was such a shit, Agatha. All the chores I did.
Yes.
Pushing her around.
Inspector Carla Valenti, would you mind if I asked you a few questions concerning
one of my investigations? Gold by 5 seconds.
Young lady, I haven't worked in investigations for a while.
I don't know what it was.
I doubt I can be much help.
5 seconds save, at least.
It's concerning an old case, but I'm still looking into it. The Kirsten case?
Because you can't locate the file, is that right?
Yes, that's right. The file's been classified.
How'd you like to do some target practice?
I thought my PB was not that bad. I don't know. I did the prompts on this attempt way faster than all my other attempts. I actually memorize them now. I have them memorized now, is what I try to say. I forgot what tune I was doing with the gun. Here's another one. Damn it.
The way you shoot, you really should come back for some more training. So, what do you want to know about the Kirsten case?
Well, for instance, what exactly happened?
A guy named Kirsten's
I didn't have enough bullets to do it.
He's in the kitchen.
I was doing
Was the killer apprehended?
He didn't. I didn't have the last bullet.
We found him sitting on the floor next to the victim like he was waiting for us, with this blank stare on his face.
Did he have any history of drug addiction, or previous psychiatric problems?
That's the first angle I looked into, but no. No drugs, no drinking, just a very normal Joe. Family man, wife and kids, good neighbor.
Maybe he just
I'll probably gold this one if we get all the prompts.
Some
good.
Some people are like time bombs just waiting to go off.
Because I got the earmuff prompt instantly, and gun prompt instantly,
talking
prompt instantly. Been pretty good.
With perfect accuracy, precision like that. I mean, The guy had a 1 in a million chance of doing that, even if he'd been a surgeon.
Gonna be a quadruple gold chain so far if this golds. I definitely don't have enough bullets for that.
I recommend that you come back for some more target practice. The way you shoot, you're likely to hurt someone out there.
You didn't stop your investigation there, did you?
No, this case really intrigued me.
Yeah, it should be gold.
What could have motivated him to do something like that? I mean, I checked
out. If not, then I'll be surprised.
And discovered almost by accident that this wasn't the first. There had been other killings with the same profile.
You mean where the killer had the same bizarre MO and stuck around afterwards?
Exactly. 3 weeks earlier, on the other side of town, another stabbing victim. In the middle of the street, no motive. Then I discovered a third case, 2 months prior to that. Then another, and another, and always the same MO.
You mean to say the killings are all connected?
No idea. All I know is that the murders were basically
identical. Probably should get the mouse
slices
out of the middle of the screen.
Leading to the heart, slices them cleanly, and then carves a symbol on his own arms.
And your investigation into the supermarket killing. Did it lead anywhere?
You should drop this one, Detective. This is not just a murder case. There's something very odd going on behind the scenes.
Looks like I'll be starting a new file.
I'd worked good and hard on the investigation, done everything Carla had asked. Now I just wanted to relax and play some b-ball. And also settle a little score I had with Jeffrey.
Yo, nice threads, Jeffrey.
Hey, what's up, Woodcox?
My man, you got me totally psyched out.
How's it going today, dude?
Right. Okay, here's the rules.
Yeah, we're on a quadruple gold chain at the moment.
And $200. That cool for you?
You can kiss your money goodbye.
We'll see. Let's do it.
Okay, can't mess any of these ones up. I really get that as the first
the
one.
You play, Jeffrey, the
okay.
You take up chess.
I mean, I've gotten that every single run, so I don't know about these cutscenes. These cutscenes might be different. Like there might be like a set amount, you know, that it goes through. I don't know. Probably not. Probably the same as the fighting rink. Oh my god. Oh, thank god. I almost missed that. That would have been so bad. I started losing it at the start of it. Gave me a curveball, I guess. Got the second long cutscene yet. Probably get it now though, since I talked about it. Of course. Here it is. Oh, that wasn't it. And that was kind of long, but it was a longer one than that. Oh, it's right here. Maybe that one, this one's longer or shorter than the other one, actually. So, I guess you do just get all the cutscenes. I've gotten all those every time.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's our play of the day.
Yo, you D up pretty good for a white cop.
So what do we get?
You're so bad yourself. You got some game.
Maybe I should have mentioned. I did some ball at college. So, as for the 100, it's game over, man.
You're a real SOB, Tyler.
I know. And that's why you like me, Jeffrey.
Gonna be a fiver? No. I lost a second? What? Fine.
Lucas Kane.
Master Noctilan, Katanakli, Corpitlan, Arnitlan,
Master Noctilan, Kashtoshi, Quecticlan Nar. There you go. God, I almost missed that. This makes my hands sweat. What the hell? It's intense. the music. I can't miss one or else I'm dead. You need to fail some here so you can lose some lives for the ending, or else the ending fight's gonna go on for a while.
Lucas is terrifying story.
But I don't know, actually, since the last input is
to talk to him, I had to find out what Agatha
before the ending. I don't know, the timing in this game is kind of weird.
Never been to his apartment before.
It should probably be after all the Simon Says sequences, to be honest.
Lucas Kane, that's it.
Makes more sense.
Lucas? Lucas, open the door! Lucas! I could swear I heard a scream coming from inside. The doorman said Lucas was at home, but he isn't open. Lucas is in danger. I've got no other choice. Lucas! Oh my God!
Longer depressed. Nice.
Lucas, for God's sake, have you lost your mind? What's come over you?
The walls were blown away, and the wind, the tempest, I...
Why did you do this, Lucas? Why?
Somebody tried to kill me.
For heaven's sake, Lucas, there's no one else here but you and I. You were all alone when I arrived. All alone, Lucas.
What's happening to me, Marcus? I don't know what's happening!
It'll be all right, Lucas. Everything will be fine. I'm gonna help you. You'll see.
Earlier you said something about the STA timing on that guy's run. The beginning of the game is around 4 minutes 53 seconds, around there. To do the first cutscene into pushing X. Unfortunately.
Sure took your time.
I was in the shower. What do you got?
I got nothing.
Got the other prompts pretty good, though.
Impossible to ID the page marker found in the book from the restaurant. It's got a series of numeric codes written on it, but it just looks like a lot of numbers to me. I thought you might have some ideas.
Why don't you fax it to me? I wasn't tired anyway, and I'm sure it'll make for good bedtime reading.
Okay, I'll send it now. If you get any brainstorms, give me a ring. I'll be here for a while. Tonight's gonna be a long one.
Okay, talk to you later, Tyler.
Hmm.
This section should be pretty good. As long as I don't mess up any of these. I know what the prompts are now. That was kind of weird. It like switched over to the desk prompts for a split second. Oh, not too bad, I guess.
Oh man, nothing but stock quotes. How can anyone possibly decipher these things?
I think this one's down for him. For his phone.
I gotta call Carter right away.
Pretty positive that's what it is. Yep.
Hello?
In Carla's office is left.
Carla, our bookmark was printed in a bank.
Of course.
Or
it's so obvious.
When you're Carla in the office, it's left for the phone.
I opened the paper to the stock
fucking
quotes
weird.
Page, and it was right under my nose the whole time. Now we just have to figure out which bank printed it.
I think I have an idea. I'll call you right back. Who could that be at this hour? Not expecting anyone.
I was feeling kind of bored, and thought as my official friendly neighbor you'd agree to share my boredom. And this excellent bottle of French Chablis.
In my capacity as your friendly neighbor, I wouldn't think of refusing your boring invitation or your excellent wine, Tommy.
I imagine that even a die-hard bachelorette like yourself must have some wine glasses around here somewhere.
I think I do have some. Somewhere. Sit down, Tommy. I'll find them.
Oh, I almost missed that. Holy crap. I almost went to the other ones. That would have been bad. Ugh, that was bad. Oh well. Probably gonna be even, or I'm gonna lose time.
A toast?
Or am I gold?
All right.
Who knows?
What to?
To love. What else?
I'll drink to that.
Just a girl with fadeaway curves to expose all she knows. You play like.
Are you with anyone?
Well, actually, I did meet someone 2 weeks ago. He's very real and very nice. And he works in a bank, too. I think this time it could turn into something serious.
It's weird that that one doesn't have an X on it.
Tarot cards?
I'm going to read your future.
You mean you know how to use those things?
My grandmother was a psychic. She taught me how to read the cards when I was just a kid. She handed down her seeing powers to me. It really works, you know. What the cards foretell always come to pass. Let's see if you're going to meet your true soulmate, or if you're going to die as a wrinkled old maid.
Okay, Mr. Gypsy. Tell me what I'm supposed to do.
It's easy. First, take the cards and mix them up. Take two cards. There's going to be a dark period, an escape, and terrible danger. Take two more cards. You're not alone. You're following someone, and he is disturbing. He hides a heavy secret. Take two more cards, please. There is a curse. great suffering and fear. I see dark death and distress. Yes, just come to me whenever you need cheering up. Seriously, I'm sorry, Carla. This is not turning out to be as much fun as I thought.
It's okay, Tommy. Let's see what horrors my destiny holds for me. Here are two more cards.
One child. Two destinies. A path toward life. The other path toward...
Man, I wish Tyler's dialogue on the next chapter didn't lose time. It'd be kind of cool to switch it up whenever you want.
Usually don't express anything like
Fortunately, his beginning is slow.
Don't apologize, Tommy. It's just a silly game.
He's coming into the room.
Anyway.
Well, I've got to get home. It's late. Hey, since when are you interested in investments?
It's about one of my investigations. I thought maybe you could help me with a question I have. I was wondering, is there a way to identify a bank from a list of stock quotes that they've printed?
From your facts, no. But normally the original document is printed on watermarked paper, showing a numeric ID code identifying the bank.
The ID code is printed on a watermark? All right, I'll check our document to see. Thanks, Tommy. Good night.
Good night, Carla.
That's it. I've got to call Tyler.
Good movement.
Yeah.
Our bookmark should be watermarked with the bank's ID code.
I'll check it out and call you right back.
I gotta sit down. Like left or right. Yeah. Turn on the light, which is down. Left. I didn't know the last one. Just gotta remember it's the same as the chair.
I think I found it.
Tyler?
I've got the code. You should have no trouble identifying which bank it corresponds to.
Let's see what we get here.
This time we've got our killer.
I did make a couple mistakes, but prompts were pretty good.
Do you want me
to go? No, I'd rather go myself if you don't mind. I'd like to see what our boy looks like. We'll meet afterwards at the station and compare notes. See you tomorrow, Tyler.
Okay, see you then, Carla.
Nice.
I finally convinced Marcus to let me go out.
Barely.
I slept most of the day. He'd stay to watch over me. I needed to get out and get back in touch with reality. My physical condition was deteriorating rapidly. My mental state wasn't much better. I could feel myself.
I could probably sit down and wait for Carla here too.
Before I lost it.
Probably lose his time standing up.
Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti, NYPD.
The police, they found me.
I don't want to try it, but I'm not going to. Just stand up.
Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti, NYPD. You are Lucas Kane, right? I'd like to ask you a couple of questions.
Questions? What about?
I'm working on a homicide case, and we have reason to believe that the murderer worked at this bank.
What do you want to know?
Could you confirm that this list came from here at the bank?
Well, this could have come from almost anywhere, really.
You should take a closer look. Your bank's ID code is on the watermark. That means it must have come from here.
I wasn't paying attention. Obviously, this paper was printed out from here.
Is there a way to establish where it was printed from?
Difficult to say. Everybody who works at the bank has access to this paper, you know.
Your manager told me that this kind of paper was only used by your stock buyers to print out their quotes.
That's correct. But there are at least 100 buyers here, so how do we know which one it is?
Is there a problem, Mr. Kane?
Huh? Oh, no, sorry.
Is there a way to determine where this particular document was printed out?
No, not really. Our printers don't leave any identifiable marks.
A witness helped us make a composite photo of the suspect. Would you mind taking a look at it for us? This remind you of anyone?
Actually, not that bad of a picture.
Hey, this looks like a lot of people I know. Could even be me.
You're right, these composites can be a little vague. Have you noticed anything unusual here at the bank lately?
No, nothing. You know, nothing much ever happens in a bank. It's pretty quiet.
I love the dialogue of this game. So good.
Well, strangely, yesterday afternoon.
Yeah, I had a little problem. I didn't really think it was that big of a deal.
Did something happen to your arms?
Oh, I had a stupid accident doing some home repair work. I guess I'm not much of a Mr. Fix-It guy.
Is that you in the picture with the priest? Is he a friend of yours?
That's my brother, Marcus. I'm not feeling very well. I'm just gonna go and splash some water on my face.
Go right ahead. I'll wait for you here. He's acting so strangely. I better.
Oh yeah, you gotta be in front. So stupid. Can't grab it from the side of the desk.
I'll take that. Shakespeare, just like the one in the restaurant. That's worth checking out. I'll just remove it discreetly.
I wonder if you could just leave. I don't know.
Feeling better?
Gonna see if there's a prompt on the door.
I don't have any more questions. I'll let you
get
back
to now.
Thank you for your cooperation, sir.
The noose is tightening. The police are closing in on me. They'll be back, and next time, they'll take me in. Agatha was my last chance. She's the only one who seems to understand what's happening to me. I just hope this time, she'll give me some answers.
Agatha? Agatha! It's Lucas!
Someone just went out the window.
Sir, I need to get your name before I can record your message. Sir, the police cruiser will be there in just a few minutes. Can you hear me, sir?
Agatha.
And now we get the glitched camera. Bottom one is not supposed to be there.
New York police, anybody there? Hey Kevin, call an ambulance. There's a body on the floor.
What the heck? I forgot to save my splits, obviously. I thought I switched them around, but I guess not.
I didn't expect you so soon. Be a good boy and preheat the oven. Oh, and pour us a couple of glasses of champagne.
Guess I didn't save them. I totally switched them. I did. I swear. I just didn't save them, I think.
Hello, Detective Miles. Do you know what day it is today?
Well, we already had Christmas, so 4th of July? No, that's summer. No, you got me.
Tyler.
Okay, babe. It's been exactly 2 years since I met the woman of my dreams.
You want to put some music on? I feel like dancing.
Ugh. Maybe it was this one that got easier. Maybe that's how the prompts actually are. Guess I'm about to find out. Oh yeah, I guess it is the same. Never mind. Down on the right one every time.
Now I had all the pieces of the puzzle. I just needed to put them all together to find our murderer. On my desk lay all the information from Nazer and Jones. On Tyler's desk, the clues from the restaurant. The identity of the killer was here somewhere.
Oh, I missed it. Oh.
No.
The page mark corresponds exactly with the stock list found.
Man, this would have been so good.
He definitely tore his bookmark from this page. I've got my first link. I'll need another in order to establish proof that Kane is our man. Detective Valenti.
Hi, Carla. It's Gary.
I know all these ones.
The taxi company should have sent.
Just the movement is a little wonky. From the same street as. Could have switched the camera, honestly.
It should be on the fax in your office.
Thanks. Bye, Garrett.
Bye, Carla.
The two books are from the same collection and have the same dedication. They obviously belong to the same person. This time, there's no reasonable doubt. Lucas Kane is the restaurant killer. I've got to tell Tyler right away.
Whoa, I almost got that on accident. Good thing I pushed left, because that's the dialogue, or that's the prompt.
Don't answer it, lover.
Weird, my phone's ringing too.
Sorry, babe. I need to answer it. It might
I
be
need to answer it. It might be important.
Tyler, no!
Hello?
We got him,
Tyler. I'll call him back.
I'm on my way.
Tyler, I'm warning you. If you leave me now, I will never forgive you.
I won't be long, babe. Just sip some champagne and I'll be right back before you know it. I'm sorry, Sam, but this is really important.
What about me? I'm not important? Tyler!
Nice. Still got a gold. I guess getting prompts faster than is better than getting better movement. I don't know. My PB, I don't think I had bad movement there.
Sorry, we're closed. Come back tomorrow.
It'd be good if I could get both, but. Oh, that's the spell. I just realized that's the same phrase he tells Lucas in his apartment. That's his spell phrase.
I finally put all of the pieces together. All that's left is to arrest the killer. Captain Jones has given us everything we asked for. There's no chance of him escaping.
Okay, this is it. Everybody in position.
Copy that.
I'll go in first. You cover me.
Okay.
Let's go left first.
Damn, what the hell is this?
Cover me. I'm gonna check the doors.
We missed him. Well, he's running now.
He's running across the street. What should I do, Carla?
Stop him. We're coming.
Copy that.
It happened again. Somebody died in the lavamatic. I saw it like I was there. Agatha's dead, so who's gonna tell me what's going on?
Put your hands in the air!
Damn, the police. They already found me. I'll spend the rest of my days rotting in prison, but I'll never find out what really happened. No, it's not gonna happen like that.
Alright, here comes a huge time save.
Did you see what that guy just did? Shit, that's crazy.
We need to catch him. Next time, he won't get away.
Oh, never mind.
5 men in the hospital. 4 wrecked squad cars. A helicopter that just missed blowing up in our faces. Meanwhile, the killer takes a nice quiet
I couldn't
ride
remember.
On the subway. I hope there's a good explanation for all this.
Nobody could have predicted the way things went down, Captain. We should have had him no problem, but the guy pulled some unpredictable
stuff. Oh, that's right. As both the memories.
This is not the Sunday driver we thought he was.
Just what are you trying to tell me here? That this guy is Superman? That's your excuse? And you seriously expect me to buy that crap?
We underestimated Kane. There's no denying it. We knew he was dangerous, but not that he could knock out trained armed policemen and then escape hanging under a helicopter.
I don't give a crap about your two-bit excuses. When the press finds out that Kane slipped through our fingers, they're gonna make me a laughingstock, and the mayor's gonna come looking for my head. Now, what is the plan, people?
Are then we gotta get the time team? Save at Tiffany's house.
Kane's photo will
with
be
the TV.
Car, train station,
so,
and
that's gonna be cool.
He puts 1 foot outside and we'll
don't know how much time that saves.
I want every available man on Kane's ass right now. I want him locked up tight in 48 hours or less. You understand me? I want this nut job behind bars before he decides to cut somebody else. Now, get out of here.
Carla, I've been looking for you. We found some of Kane's prints in an apartment where we found the dead body of an old lady. And that's not all. There was a double murder last night in a lavamatic. One of the two victims was killed by knife blows to the
heart. Might be able to get it this run, honestly.
He's waiting for you.
Who knows? Maybe with game time. Yeah, I've got it in my notes. Everything should be good.
Agatha? Agatha, is that you? I thought you were...
dead. In a way. But I promised to tell you what I know, and I always keep my word. Listen carefully, Lucas. We have very little time. You are not insane. Neither are you a murderer. You were simply at the wrong place, at the wrong time.
Why did they make me commit that murder?
We also have the Kiryakin time save. Jesus. This is going to be quite the time if I don't mess anything up.
They are looking for a little girl. They'll do anything to get her.
Why do I have these visions? They are real, aren't they?
In a way, yes. They are using the visions to try and eliminate you. You've seen too much, so you've become an inconvenience. They're coming. Save yourself, Lucas. They want your life. Kuetnitlan, in the ancient Mayan civilization. You'll find some of the answers you seek there.
Agatha? Agatha!
Agatha?
Lucas! Lucas, wake up! What are you doing here? What happened? The police.
Oh, okay.
I managed to get away. I walked all night.
Makes sense.
I didn't have anywhere else to go, so I came here.
Yeah, that's what I figured it should be.
This time you really have to go to the police, Lucas. There is no other solution. I'm not turning myself in until I understand what happened. Someone tried to kill me through my visions. They can attack me anywhere. I think they want to prevent Agatha from talking to me. This is all a bit much, Lucas. What if this whole thing is all in your head? Isn't it at least possible that you're losing your grip on reality? I'm not crazy, Marcus. I used to think maybe I was, but now I'm sure that something's going on here.
Down. Hello, Agatha. Game.
Here, just a
while. How many times I gotta push it?
She's dead, but Jesus. She had some things to tell me. I think she wants to help me. Agatha is dead?
Guess I was doing diagonal.
No, I didn't kill Agatha, Marcus. She was dead by the time I got there. But you're saying that you talked to a dead person? None of this makes any sense. So what are you going to do? You can't stay here. The police will certainly come to question me, and probably place me under surveillance. I have to find some place to hide. I'm a fugitive. My description will go out everywhere. At least now I know that there is an explanation. I need to find the people who are behind all of this. Be careful, Lucas. They'll kill you if they get the chance. Nothing could be worse than what I see in my visions. Agatha talked about the Mayans. It's vague, but it's all I've got to go on. I've got to find a place to hide while I figure this out. There's only one person who can help me.
-5 degrees Fahrenheit. Every day it got a little colder. The whole
city was covered
by snow and ice. But nobody was worried about it yet.
The fuck is going on?
I'm gonna talk to Garrett and see if he found anything.
Nice camera, dude.
Cool with me. I can't even think out here.
Snaps back.
I was waiting for you, Carla.
So, what happened here?
The guy who runs the Lab-O-Matic found the bodies around 5 o'clock.
Good camera, dude. To open up. That was awesome.
When he tried to get in, it seemed like the door was blocked from the inside. He saw the two bodies through a window and called the cops.
What do we know about the victims?
The man was called Jose Lopez. He works here and was supposed to close up last night. The woman's name was Anita Martinez. She did her laundry here on a regular basis.
Were there any prints?
Just those of the victims. No prints from Kane, if that's what you're wondering.
Thanks, Garrett.
Pretty chapter. Whatever. Just finish it, honestly. Get it over with.
Stuck in his eye. Death would have been instantaneous. Bizarre. His wrists are all cut up. Looks like some kind of symbol carved on them. Snake. Snake with two heads.
Yeah, I lied. Agatha wasn't the worst section. This is the worst section.
Yeah, I saw that. What do you think it means?
2 hours of the game.
That the murderer was
not too bad
before he stabbed his victim. Just like in the toilets of the restaurant. Three or four stabs in the area of the heart. Exactly like the victim in the restaurant. I wouldn't be surprised if the autopsy finds that the arteries were severed.
I'm getting used to the artery word now. I've heard it so many times when running this game the last couple days.
Let's go. I've seen enough. What are we supposed to think about this murder? The guy committed suicide after killing the woman? It seems absurd, but the only explanation.
It's still gnarly.
I don't think Kane had any
if I start thinking about it too hard.
But
All the same, there's got to be a link between the two murders.
It's not a good thought. Okay, I still got a gold in that section. That's fine.
I was exhausted.
No problem.
Either from the cold or from hunger. I hoped that I could rest for a couple of hours at Tiffany's place. Get my energy back. And
figure I don't know. I guess my PB didn't save or some shit. No, it definitely saved. This was just a bad PB, I guess.
They're watching Tiffany's apartment, of course. They assumed that I'd show up here looking for a place to hide. I have to find another way in.
Okay. Wow, I almost missed it. Haha. Funny.
The police. There must be some way to get around.
That's always intense. If I miss one, I always like freak out. I push up here. Okay, I'll probably just mash pretty fast anyway. I don't know. All right.
That window leads to Tiffany's apartment. If only I could find a way to open it.
Just gonna mash like this. This will be fine.
I think it.
I just won't mash super fast, I guess. Steady mashing. We'll do it.
It's open a few inches. Almost had it.
Yay. This is longer than Tyler's section almost. That was fun, wasn't it?
I wasn't too proud about breaking into Tiffany's apartment as a common criminal, but I had no choice. I hadn't eaten in almost a day. I was starting to feel weak and tired.
We won't be able to see how much time this saves until the next chapter.
And for an expert's point of view on the subject, we have with us today one of the most renowned specialists on Mayan civilization, Professor Dmitri Kuryakin of the Mesoamerican University here in New York.
Then again, if I fix my splits, we won't be able to see how much time it saved on these two.
A specialist in Mayan civilization.
Oh, because you think the timer keeps running?
Gotta meet this Professor Kuryakin.
That's shitty. Thought it was gonna be huge. Isn't this waiting timer only a minute, though? Or is it a minute regardless? But know that first TV station's not a minute long. Starts as soon as you enter this room. Oh. Oh, that sucks. It was a good idea, though, I guess. That wasn't too bad. Didn't feel like very long.
Police are looking for me. I needed a place to hide for a few hours.
Lucas, what happened to you? The papers are saying that you killed several people. Is it true?
The whole thing is very complicated.
I'm excited to watch this scene with Tyler.
I know you're not capable of doing what they said you did, Lucas. You have to explain. You have to tell them you're innocent.
I've got to find out exactly what's happened to me, Tiffany. That's the only way I can prove my innocence.
Lucas, it's the police. What are we gonna do?
Look, I'm sure they just want to ask you a few questions. Just stay calm, Tiffany, and answer their questions. I'll hide in the apartment. Everything will be fine. You'll see.
Miss Harper? Miss Harper, are you home?
Yes, just a second. I'm coming. Lucas, I can't keep them waiting anymore. I've got to open the door.
Miss Harper?
Yes?
I'm working on the Lucas King.
Right when he walks in. Oh, it's gonna be there.
We're involved,
oh my
yes.
God.
But we separated. We broke up about a month ago.
Have you heard from Mr. Kane recently?
That's so stupid.
Has he tried to contact you?
I went by his apartment day before yesterday to pick up the last of my things. We hardly spoke.
Where?
I haven't heard from him since.
Do you mind if I look around your apartment?
Where is he?
Well, it's just that...
Hey, I'll only be a minute.
Go ahead.
So dumb.
Doing a
little redecorating. This is great.
Yes, the apartment.
This game is the best,
shape, so
yeah, for sure.
It's taking a long time with my job. I don't have much time to.
And what do you do?
I'm a nurse.
Ridiculous.
I work at St. John's Hospital.
Even the guy standing at the door would be able to find a vest in Tyler. Fuck. Doesn't say anything, I guess. See the reason now.
Thank you for your cooperation, miss. If Kane does try to recontact you, please call me right away. Here's my card. Be careful, miss. Kane's a very dangerous man.
Hello.
That was great.
Barney.
I'm glad that's better than the closet.
You've come to see Janus, isn't that right? He's down the second corridor on the right. When you're finished.
You see the bottom of his shoes the whole time he's in the room.
Six times today.
Like, come on. Come on, Tyler.
Good thing the hospital's got its own backup generator. Remember, Janus's cell is down the second corridor on the right. One of my colleagues is waiting to open the cell for you. I'll be watching you. Don't worry, you'll be fine.
Thank you, Barney. I wasn't sure exactly what I expected to find out by coming here. Kane was the killer. There was no doubt about that. And yet, I needed to know just what
nice.
Happened.
Nice. That was pretty good movement.
Hello, detectives. I'll wait for you here.
Right in there.
Thanks.
I think I said dialogue. I don't remember. Pretty good movement. I'm thinking of dialogue now, so maybe that's why I thought I said that.
Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti of the New York Police Department. I'd like to ask you a few questions, if it's all right with you, of course. Could we talk a little about Kirsten? What really happened in the store?
Why have you gone to the trouble of coming to see me, Detective Valenti? I'm mad, you know. What I have to say is meaningless. Isn't that right?
Maybe it'll make sense to me. Please, Anton, tell me everything that you know.
A man and a woman in a laundromat. She's a little overweight.
Nice.
Panic looking. Him. He has a knife planted in his eye.
How do you know that?
I was there. I can see through his eyes.
That's
Everyone
good to know.
Knows. I'm there.
What happened in the laundromat?
The sacrifice. A human sacrifice.
Well, we're about to beat it again.
The killer and his victim.
Gotta make sure I don't
And you, Anton, why did you kill
Fuck
him?
Up. I thought I actually fucked up that dialogue.
It was just
but
his instrument.
It's good.
I hear his voice in my head.
That's probably wrong anyway, but whatever.
Always.
I got the
always,
right dialogue that he used. At least.
It has to stop.
Why are these killings happening?
Hey, what's up, Blue?
Why must these people die?
How's it going today?
Oh, the world's not what you think it is. The Orange Clan is secretly running everything. They're watching us, listening to us all of the time. They record what you say. They know what you're doing each second of the day. They're everywhere.
How is this connected to the murders?
The
want ultimate power.
Boring,
they
but good. Nice. At least it's
they
good.
Want to be eternal.
I have to go now, Anton. Thank you for your help.
It's already too late. We're all gonna die from the cold.
So, DB found a bunch of cool time saves in the run, which is why we're 2 minutes ahead right now. We would only be like 1 minute ahead if I didn't mess up in my PB previously, but...
Everything go all right? I'll walk you to the...
Right now,
damn it.
We're on pretty good shape, and then we're about to come up on another good time save.
Generator hasn't kicked in.
Going to save us a bunch.
Sometimes it takes a minute.
And then I just have to not mess up on the second memory.
What was that noise?
And then we'll save another good amount of time.
All of this.
Yeah, DB found like a shit ton of time saves.
Must have screwed up the autolock system.
Apparently I already have record at the moment.
You mean the patients are free
to leave? So right now we're just trying to get it really low.
Don't make any noise. We don't want them to locate us here. Just keep cool and we'll wait for the lights to come on. Relax. Stay close to me.
The aid. They got him. I have to move from here or they'll find me too. If I don't breathe more calmly, I'm gonna faint. And then they get me for sure. Oh no! I hear one coming. He's getting so close. Freeze, Carla. Move. Hold your breath.
All right. Gotta wait till her dialogue pops up to move again. Pretty easy.
He's right there.
When I first played this, I didn't have subtitles. I didn't know that.
He's going away. I can keep moving.
I kept failing here because I didn't know when to move again. I must have failed this part like 4 times when I first played this game.
Barney! Barney! Open up!
Alright. Let's see what kind of time save we're gonna get. It was a pretty good chapter.
Thank God you made it out. I don't know what the hell could have happened. The auto lock system.
Mostly gonna be time save from the last chapter, The Fugitive. My
sure
time saves
right?
are just kinda. Or my splits are just messed
Barney.
Up.
I feel great. I love playing hide and seek in the dark with a pack of psychopathic killers.
Nice. Good amount of time. We're about to save a bunch of time.
This man I'd barely seen on TV was my last hope. I didn't know what connection there could be between the Mayans and what had happened to me. But at that point, I was ready to accept any
giant big gold
make sense out of the night
huge
my life had become. Hello, I'm a journalist and I have an appointment with Professor Kuryakin.
The professor's waiting for you.
Professor Kuryakin?
Yes.
My name's John Cunningham. We spoke on the phone. I'm a journalist, and I'm gathering information for an article I'm writing about the Mayan religion.
Ah, yes, I've been waiting for you, young man. What paper did you say you write for once again?
I write for the New York Times.
It's curious, but your face seems familiar to me. Have we met somewhere before?
Yeah, I get that a lot. I guess I must have one of those boring
There's already
faces.
A second save.
He's everywhere.
But that's not where the huge time save.
Let's have a go at it. Where would you like to start?
Can you tell me anything about Kuwechnitlan?
Of course. Come, I'll introduce you. You see before you the ancient Mayan god Kuwechnitlan, the serpent with the two heads. One head sees in this reality, the second in the other world. By opening both mouths, the Mayan oracles could see through the serpent into the other world.
Could you explain this other world?
or the world beyond our own, the kingdom of the gods and the dead. The Mayans believed that human sacrifices allowed them to hear the voices of the deceased and see into the future.
Tell me, how did the sacrificial ceremony work?
Come, I'll show you.
Just have him push me. Oh, it didn't work. No. No.
This spider, dating from the first century BC, shows a sacrificial ceremony.
Well, I'm not doing that ever again. I thought it was just a good strat. But apparently not.
Keep the mouths open as long as possible.
Because I got lucky the first time. The first time I tried that, it worked instantly.
Pulmonary artery leading to the heart.
How did the ritual sacrifice work?
Oh, the Oracle must never soil himself with the blood of another. That is why he chooses a sort of proxy. Another person.
Could probably just reset, right?
Totally random. This person becomes executed.
Funny, but not funny.
The Oracle takes complete control of the executor, manipulating him from a distance.
A Mayan sacrifice. That's what it was.
You aren't a journalist, are you? Who are you?
My name is John Cunningham, and I am indeed a journalist, as I've already told you. I think I've taken enough of your time, Professor. Thank you for the information.
As you wish. It's a shame, though, that you won't tell me more. Now, if I were you, I'd leave here by the employee's exit. The security guard's been reading an article showing your photo, and I'm afraid that he may soon recognize you.
Thank you for your help, Professor.
Maybe it's 2 to 15 seconds. Yeah, I gotta... Nah, fuck this. Wanted to be sure I wasn't gonna miss that. Here we go. Woo! Dude, that's a huge time save. Big. Okay, we can't mess up the second
I've been looking for
memory.
Meeting you.
I'm gonna be sure not to mess it up.
Capable of resisting an oracle. What is there so different about you?
Yeah, it probably could be a little bit better than 405.
You have the
if I got like everything really
so
fast.
That explains it. How did you ever acquire such a power? No matter. What matters?
Maybe like a 407, maybe, even.
The chroma? What does that mean?
The force that created the universe. The origin of everything. It gives extraordinary powers to those who possess it.
Why do I have to die? I pose no threat to you.
The sacrifice has created a link between our souls.
My hands are sweating. if that tells you anything.
The only way to break the link is for one.
Either my house is too hot or I'm just a little nervous.
Enough talk. Other matters await my attention. We will see each other again in the other world.
Oh my god, stop. It's not that hard, it's just Simon Says. Agatha?
But how?
Listen closely, Lucas. Those who employ the Oracle are searching for a little girl. A perfectly pure soul that's never been incarnated. Her coming was foretold by the most ancient prophecy in human history.
Yeah, we're pretty close
to the
end now.
She's the one you see in your dreams. You must find
her before
the Oracle does and put her someplace safe. Hurry. There isn't much time, and they are already back on your trail.
I must inform you that we are unhappy.
Very unhappy.
He has escaped you again.
First in the museum lot.
A big mistake, the museum lot.
And then in the wave. What's worse? You showed yourself openly to him.
And all for nothing.
It's just... I was unaware of certain factors, my lords.
Which factors?
He possesses the chroma.
That's impossible.
Idiocy!
How could he possess the chroma?
I know not.
Oh yeah, you see those gold splits? 100% skill.
Oracle is in Marcus's church. There's not
like going by a tiny bit every time.
We should wait, Carla. Backup will be here any minute now.
No way. This time I'm gonna get him. The desk guy swore to us that he was in his room, and he's not gonna get away.
I hope that guy didn't screw up when he said he recognized Kane's photo from the papers. He looked so blind he wouldn't recognize his own mother in a phone booth.
We'll find the answer in room 369.
Just pick up.
Hello, my son. What can I do for you?
Rip.
Sir, can I help you with something?
Where is he hiding?
Marcus! No! 369. Here it is.
Man, what was this camera? What the hell?
Nobody move!
Either he's gone through some changes since the photo, the
guy
or
on
this
the left.
Shit.
Well, face.
What the hell happened?
Calm down, girl. I think there's been a slight misunderstanding.
Tyler, it was the wrong room.
Huh?
There must be another room through 69 down the hall somewhere.
I think the bird has flown the coop.
I'm gonna find him, Tyler. I promise you.
Come on, let's go.
Spider-Man. Taught Lucas how to hang from ceilings or the top of window seals, I guess.
Lucas, you have to come over right now.
Spider-Lou, Spider-Lou.
I am not joking. So please, don't delay.
Nice.
I'm moving towards my death. Everything that I've been through since the second I entered that diner, all of it was leading me to this moment. I was tired of fighting, running, and hiding all the time. I was losing anyway. There was only one thing left to do. Try to save Tiffany's life.
That was a pretty good chapter.
I decided not to fight my destiny.
Got everything almost instantly.
Lucas! Lucas, help me!
Except for maybe going
Tiffany.
To the door.
She's at the
first
top of
six,
the roller coaster.
369 door.
I have to find a way up there.
That was a little slow. Wonder if I could get that without stopping. Can probably get it if I like angle myself towards it.
Lucas!
Just hard to do that with the camera switch. Oh my god. Horrible movement. Movement there is really weird. Just awkward as fuck.
It's a trap! They're trying to kill you!
It's a trap! They're gonna kill you!
They got it wrong, but got the tone right. Oh my god! Oh god! No, I'm scared. Just go across the fucking pole already. So fucking finicky. Oh fuck. Oh shit. That was so close. Holy crap. So stupid. Why would you do that? Oh God!
It's over.
I could kill myself. My heart's gonna stop. Your heart stopped as well.
I sense another signal.
Cerebral spinal activity. I think he's dreaming.
Fuck. Okay, let's not fuck this up.
Wake up, Marcus, it's time.
Stop before the staircase. Wait till he completely turns his head.
Are you sure you want to go?
It should be good.
It could be dangerous.
We have to go in there ready for anything, Marcus, right? Maybe there'll be an alien spaceship inside, or the tomb of an ancient king and all of his treasure.
Twice. Turns his head twice. Dinosaur? Not once.
And what if it's a secret weapon to take over the world?
Come on, let's hurry. The hangar's gonna be well guarded. We better get going if we don't want Mom and Dad to catch us.
Oh my god, I almost just fucked that. I went for it.
Further. That soldier's blocking the way.
One of us should sneak around the back and find a way to avoid him.
Wait for Marcus before going on.
I don't know if he can go to the right, left there, but I'm not gonna try it. Might be like an invisible wall.
Now what?
The only way to get to the hangar without being seen is to climb up the telephone pole and hang off of the cable.
Impossible! That pole is right under the guard's nose.
I know, but there's no other way.
Listen, I'm gonna try to get him to look the other way.
Hey, let's not fuck this. Boss swoopty swoops.
I'll try to set it up so you have enough time.
Okay, but how are you gonna get in?
I'll meet you back at the house. You tell me everything when you get back. At least that way we'll know for sure whether there's a flying.
We're pretty calm right now. We should be alright. After my heart almost stopped, I don't think I could get excited again for a little bit.
It's all up to you, Lucas.
Hey, what do you think you're doing there?
I'm looking for my cat, sir. He ran out of the house. He was on the garbage, but then he got away before I could grab him.
You're one of the Kane boys, right? Head on home, son. You shouldn't be out prowling around alone at this hour.
That might have been cat, bad.
Sir? We'll find him tomorrow. Right now, you go on back home.
That scared me. Be able to keep going. But I stalled at the beginning of that one. Stop here. I haven't tried going here. Okay, well, it looks pretty good. Just follow the route here. Could be good. Very good. No major mistakes. Gotta open the door here. I actually did not know that prompt. I knew it was either left or right.
He is dead, my lords.
Good.
Very good.
Now so
this
you
is checkmate.
The Indigo child as soon as possible.
There isn't much time. The visions are becoming clearer and clearer. I've nearly got a position localized.
Maybe not. I don't know.
Time is short.
The child must not escape us.
The prophecy must be fulfilled. You may leave us.
Apparently I lost time. Okay.
When I got the call, I didn't hesitate for one second. I came without telling anybody, not even Tyler. All I knew
I don't know how.
I was supposed to go to the grave with somebody who'd just been buried this morning. Tiffany Harper.
Saved it.
Lucas Kane's ex-girlfriend.
I almost went to that one.
She was a good person.
Okay.
She didn't have anything to do
dialogue.
With
dialogue.
You got a lot of guts, Mr. Kane. Call my office and ask for a meeting when every cop in the country is hot on your trail. I didn't see that coming.
Your investigation has too many shadowy areas in it for you to content yourself with the official version. You're here because you think I might have the answers to your questions.
Well then, who is the real killer?
I don't know his name. I don't even know if there's anyone alive who does. All that I do know is that he's a Mayan oracle who has the power to erase all memory of his existence from anyone who sees him.
The oracle isn't acting alone, is he?
He belongs to a secret clan who have united the most powerful beings on Earth. Their power has no limit, and they'll do anything to get the Indigo Child.
You mean the Orange Clan?
You already know about them?
I went to see one of the murderers in an asylum. He talked about the Orange Clan. And you? What's your role in all of this?
I was just a random victim of the Oracle. Nothing more.
How did you learn all of this?
I just know, that's all. The question isn't whether what I'm saying is true or not. The question is, are you going to help me?
Why are you telling me all of this?
I think his serious tone is so funny sounding.
Knows that what I'm saying is true.
And even if you're right, what can we do about it? Nobody's gonna believe all this. And if the Oracle really has all these powers, what can we do to stop him?
Find the Indigo Child before he does, and hide her someplace safe.
Do you know where she is?
Not yet, but I'll find her. I see through the eyes of the Oracle during his visions. If he sees her, I'll see her.
Oh, this is just insane. I cannot believe I'm actually sitting here talking about saving the world with a fugitive wanted by every police department in the country.
You're free to choose which side you're on. You can arrest me, or you can trust me and help me save the child. But you must decide quickly. I haven't got much time.
So, either you're crazy, or you're some kind of hero.
Neither one nor the other. I was just in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Get ready. Get ready for the handshake. Yeah, that movement lost me that time. Whatever.
Ugh, fuck.
Slytherin house.
Country is now without water and electricity services. The army has been mobilized to help provide shelter and basic necessities, but the cold and snow have hampered ground movement and
five more sections
in the country,
including this one. Oh yeah, we're almost done. We just have that one big Oracle fight left.
The entire planet.
Then we get to watch some more cutscenes.
Well, our job is done. Now it's up to the army to do what they can to help the population. Carla, you should get some sleep. You haven't closed your eyes in 2 days.
I have to get warm to do that. I'm solid ice from head to toe.
Yeah. Hey, look, can I get real with you here for a sec, Carla?
I think it's probably now or never.
I get the feeling you're hiding something from me on this Kane thing. Am I right?
I think it's probably better if you stay out of all this, Tyler. This whole thing is
yeah, Tyler, jeez. Some kind of partner you are.
Sam, what are you doing here, babe?
There's a train leaving in 1 hour.
The most emotion in this game is that face that he gives her.
And come with me. When this cold stops, we'll get on with our lives, our new normal lives. It's time to make a choice, Tyler.
Oh, I love you too damn much.
True. Can't even find him under a table.
Anything in the world.
Oh, Tyler, I was so afraid of losing you.
I don't know what's going on with the lights. I just noticed that the lights are all fucked up. Kind of funny.
Carla,
as long as you do what you think is right, you can't go too wrong.
Would have been a really good chapter.
Good luck.
That last movement.
Here we are. Are you sure you know what you're doing?
Here we go. Not fail this. I'm gonna really be focusing.
He'll be here to find her any minute.
Been doing pretty good.
I've got to get to her before he does. Wait for me here. I won't be long.
I think this is a down.
There's no time to lose. I've got to find that girl before the order.
Pretty sure it is. Yeah. So weird.
Sir? Sir! You can't go in there!
Got to do this quickly. The Oracle will be here any second.
You can't go in, sir.
Bye-bye.
So, you're still alive.
Yeah, the loading times are super good.
Managed it, but that's of no importance now. You've lost the game. The child is mine. Now I'm going to put you out of my...
Crazy how fast it is on
once and
this
all.
Version. Alright, here we go.
Thank you.
One more part. Done. It's over. It's done. It's over. Oh, now I just gotta do dialogue. Gotta make sure I do all that.
We lost the child.
Agatha.
Humanity's fate for the next 10,000 years depended on the fate of that child. A new golden age, peace and security. Or the reign of ice of terror and death. We put our faith in you, and you've let us down terribly.
This child, why is she so important?
At the dawn,
and I also
of
have
time,
to get the Bogard movement good.
That one day, a child
can lose a good amount there.
One
I'd
whose
fuck
soul
it
was absolutely pure. She would come and reveal a secret, the answer to all questions. He who possessed this answer would gain unlimited power.
You're not really Agatha, are you?
No, you're right. Poor Agatha died in her.
I feel like
heart.
This dialogue is pretty right. Because you could probably just keep on going with dialogue with Agatha until you get to this one.
What happened at the amusement park?
Oh, yeah. No idea.
I don't remember anything after the roller coaster collapsed.
No clue.
You didn't survive the fall. We found your body, and we resuscitated you. The truth is that you are dead, Lucas.
Why did you bring me back to life?
Because of your connection with the Oracle, of course. You see through the mouths of the serpent at the same time he does. Only you could lead us to the child.
I forgot one small detail. When we brought you back to life, we added a module within your cortex. It's impossible to kill you, as you are already dead. I can, however, annihilate you. A simple touch from me, and you will be erased forever. There's no use trying to resist. I have control of you now.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, Lucas, hurry.
Quickly, over here.
Sorry. That was stupid.
Thank you.
Not bad.
How did you find me?
That man came and got me. He told me you needed help.
Where are we?
In an abandoned subway station, I guess. So, what do we do now?
Looks like we don't have much choice.
But follow it. You see that entity or whatever the heck it is later on.
Welcome to the camp of the invisibles, Lucas. Come and take a seat by the fire.
Like certain endings, you don't see it, I think. I think if you beat the Oracle, then it comes in after the Oracle.
Who are you?
To fight you.
We're the invisibles. Since the dawn of time, we've been secretly observing the clans. Our mission.
At least I think so.
That the Indigo child doesn't fall into the wrong hands.
Pretty sure that's right.
So, what do we do now?
We must find the Indigo child as quickly as possible. I suppose that they will bring her to a Chroma source. That's where she will deliver her message and fulfill the prophecy.
Where do we find this Chroma source?
There are only three known to exist.
It's a little confusing.
The closest could be found on an old military base called Wishita.
Wishita? That's where I was born. My parents were scientists.
It just comes out of nowhere.
And that explains many things. In the 50s, an artifact was discovered that was not of human origin. It turned out to be a Chroma source. The one who brings the Indigo child will have ultimate power for the next 10
Lit when I get the last failure? Okay.
We absolutely must.
I will for sure do that.
When do we leave?
In 2 hours, the time it'll take to finish preparations on your vehicle and to find you enough gasoline. It seems likely that the orange and the purple clans will be waiting for you at Wishita.
So then we'll have to.
Must do whatever it takes.
Are we gonna subtract the intro time from the intro cutscene or no? Probably, right? Since his time is like that.
Get some rest before you have to leave. You have a long journey ahead of you. Tomorrow may well be the last day of the human race.
Weird SDA thing. Yeah.
I'm dead tired, Carla.
It was kind of weird.
Bogart's advice and get some sleep.
I don't think I can sleep right now. I'm gonna wander around a bit and join you later.
Oh, are you a mod on the page now? Oh, gotcha. Yeah, probably be best to have all the leaderboards and somebody's controlling the community. And they're not even in the Discord or anything, I don't think.
Everything will disappear under the ice.
Well, it won't really be under your control, but at least you'll be able to change shit. Because the game is kind of a mess.
Are you afraid to die?
Not anymore.
Like the timings and the rules.
I want you to know something.
Paige.
I'm sorry that we didn't meet under better circumstances.
Paige looks okay. It's just the rules are a little bit scuffed.
Differently.
Somebody said what else I was gonna play after this. Oh, I just clicked my screen. I don't know what I'm gonna play after this.
Your lips are like ice.
Okay, it's only a second.
I love you, Lucas.
Reset. I had to do it, yeah. I was scrolling up in my chat. Whatever. I skipped it, so we can't see it. There we go. We'll be able to see it on this one, though.
He knew the hangar was going to burn, John. I'm sure of it. But he wasn't the one who started the fire.
Look, Mary,
everything else is pretty good. And you know it. A tiny pause.
Nobody can see things before they happen.
That artifact emitted a kind of radiation that we still don't understand. Maybe it changed something in Lucas.
That's nonsense.
Walking Dead runs? Not really interested in that.
Fine. Don't you see? If it was the artifact, then we'd all be radiated and we'd all
There's
have
a difference,
powers.
John.
I think you asked that like an hour ago? Oh, sorry.
Lucas was radiated by the artifact when he was still
like,
in the womb.
Yeah, concentrating mode.
I've heard enough.
Miss a lot of things in chat. My chat's not very big, Lucas? So I can only see like
what are you doing there?
4 or 5 lines of chat Lucas? At a time.
Lucas!
Damn it. Reset. Lost 5 seconds. I don't think it was that bad.
There's the hangar. The base seems abandoned. Looks like we got here before the Oracle and the Purple Clan.
They're not far away. I sense their presence.
Be careful.
Oh yeah, that's right.
I need you.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this run, regardless of those silly time losses.
If I'm not back,
it's definitely
minutes, go back where
pretty
we
good.
From. Bogart will protect you.
Yeah, I'll let you know what it is. Surprised I remembered that one.
I don't have time to play, Lucas. In a few seconds, I will hear the answer to all questions, and my clan will be the most powerful force in the universe for the next 10,000 years. It's an historic moment, the moment when humanity's elite shall become as gods.
Gods will reduce their brothers to slaves.
What difference does that make? We control them already. The secret will bring us an infinite and eternal power. Too bad you won't be there to see it. Destroy him. Ah, of course. You cannot be killed. You are already dead. I'll just have to take care of you myself.
Floating in the air. Attack me, please. There it is. The real 3:22 time. Oh gosh. Woo. Couldn't have done it without you, DV. All those time saves you found in like a day. Crazy. Just 5 minutes, no big deal. I'm kind of a big deal right now. I just got world record in Fahrenheit, you know. game that only two people has ran it. Big deal over here. Three, 22, 40. That's actually six. Six. It's sick. Pretty cool. I can improve my heavy rain run by so much.
But nothing happened. 3 months after the revelation of
I think Heavy Rain is gonna be the next game. It might take a little break from this one, and then eventually I'll time the dialogue.
Their plan will reveal itself. Carla and I have been together ever since Washita. Yesterday,
we're doing anthology world record sweep.
It must have been that night
at this point.
That means that our child was radiated by the chroma at Washita, just like I was.
Might I even move on to Beyond in Detroit?
I'm not sure what's going
on. We'll see how far I get.
Carla and I are trying to lead normal lives as though nothing had ever happened. I still
would like to get a good run on Heavy Rain, but I need to play it a bunch to learn all the prompts again. Just the beginning.
What are you thinking about, Lucas?
Beyond's going to be a
nothing.
Huge project.
Nothing at all.
Gotta like learn all the prompts in that game. I barely know that game. It took me like couple weeks to learn this one. Ooh, I got the prompts like pretty good. I know pretty much all of them except for like three or four. That's how I got with Heavy Rain. That's why it's like so good, even with the 55 second time loss. Oh yeah, I'll switch those notes, and then I'll probably upload these to the SRC page. But I do want to watch the rest of the cuts or the rest of the credits, because it's a tradition for me to watch all the credits if I get a good PB. If it deserves the credits, then we watch the credits. That's how it's always been. Like ever since I started. We definitely hammered the time down a lot. They're out so nice. I really like the mental health stuff. Like how close it is to dying towards the end. It's like perfect still. I'll be right back.
Excuses for everything, and I remember the time.
I'm back. I had to get some water. Victory water chug. I didn't even need to go to the bathroom at all. I think I just can't drink soda during runs. It really makes my bladder hate me. Like, I could probably do another run. Now I have to go. Probably not, but get like halfway through one. Pog, 200 points. Okay. Saved him.